The claims that the election was stolen were so successful, President Trump and his allies raised $250 million, nearly $100 million in the first week after the election. On November 9th, 2020, President Trump created a separate entity called the Save America PAC. Most of the money raised went to this newly created PAC, not to election-related litigation.
Irrefutable evidence proves that Trump directly stole money from his own supporters. Finally, we have the smoking gun that will still make no difference at all to them. Hypnosis is strong when it's done on stupid people. The Jan 6 Stop the Peaceful Transfer of Power deadly insurrection on our government that Trump supporters think was just a super cool multi-sensory way to tour the Capitol had another day of public televised hearings and revealed yet another smoking gun about Trump. This time, as plain as can be, that he directly stole money. It was revealed that he raised over $250 million through fundraising emails, pushing his total lie voter fraud allegations that he knew were lies for the, and I quote, official election defense fund, close quote, that the House Select Committee found out, get this, did not exist.
All of us here today do not want to see our election victory stolen by emboldened radical left Democrats, which is what they're doing.
The evidence developed by the Select Committee highlights how the Trump campaign aggressively pushed false election claims to fundraise, telling supporters it would be used to fight voter fraud that did not exist. The emails continued through January 6th, even as President Trump spoke on the ellipse. 30 minutes after the last fundraising email was sent, the Capitol was breached.
So let me try to speak directly to Trump supporters for a minute, in a more raw, emotional, simple language that they may connect with a little bit better. He told you there was an official election defense fund. There was not. He made it up. He used his imagination to make pretend so he could steal from you. So he could line his pockets and his already rich buddy's pockets with your hard-earned money. And you don't care because you are Trump's little b***h. There's no other way to say it. And I know it'll get bleeped, but I'll say it again anyway. You will let him do anything he wants to you because if you still support Trump today, you are his little b***h. He owns you. He uses you like a napkin. Quick wipe and then right in the trash. Of course, stealing hard-earned money from his own supporters is horrible, but it doesn't even hold a candle to the bigger thing these hearings are clearly showing you, that he tried and is still trying to overthrow American democracy, to end our democracy. That's our system of government. Simply because he's a sore loser. That should matter more than everything else to you, more than whatever political issue you care about most, more than gas prices, inflation, more than vaccines. If American democracy crumbles, which it's on the brink of doing, if you don't come to your senses fast, there will be no country left to fill your car up in, or spend too much for stuff in, or not protect yourself from deadly viruses in. You know, all the stuff you love. When asked at a press conference months before the election if he would guarantee a peaceful transfer of power, the very basic requirement for us to have a government of the people, aka a democracy, that we've had, you know, for hundreds of years since the country started, Trump said no.
Will you commit to making sure that there is a peaceful transfer of power after the election?
Well, we're going to have to see what happens. You know that I've been complaining very strongly about the ballots, and the ballots are a disaster.
Well, we'll have to see what happens. Meaning if I win, you get peace, but if I lose, you get violence. And he spent the next many months developing a complex 7-part plan to literally try everything possible to ignore the votes and overturn the election. 1. President Trump engaged in a massive effort to spread false and fraudulent information to the American public, claiming the 2020 election was stolen from him. Number 2. President Trump corruptly planned to replace the acting attorney general so that the Department of Justice would support his fake election claims after his current attorney general, Barr, started saying, "I know this is not true and you didn't win the election." Not good enough for Trump. Number 3, President Trump corruptly pressured Vice President Pence to refuse to count the certified electoral votes in violation of the U.S. Constitution. You know the Constitution, that thing with the Second Amendment in it? Yeah, he tried to go against that. Number 4, and I know the numbers are getting big now, so please try to keep your focus, I get it. President Trump corruptly pressured state election officials and state legislatures to change the election results. That's the government in different states. He wanted them to change it. Number five, come on, stay focused. Come on, look, isn't this fun? Cool sounds, right? President Trump's legal team and other Trump associates instructed Republicans in multiple states to create false electoral slates, basically to get electors to pretend that their state voted for him instead of Biden and submit that to Congress and to the National Archives. Number six, President Trump summoned and assembled a violent mob in Washington and directed them to march on the U.S. Capitol, which then led to the insurrection and all the death and all the horrible violence that happened there in the Capitol. And number seven, as the violence was happening, President Trump ignored multiple pleas for assistance and failed to take immediate action to stop the violence and instruct his supporters to leave the Capitol. I don't know if you're aware of this, but a man who won an election doesn't need to do seven different desperate things to beg people to overturn the results. Those are the actions of somebody who lost an election and who is a traitor to his nation and a child who can't admit that he lost, so he tries to take his toys with him. Only this time his toys are all of us. And the hearings have also proven that Trump was told by most of his team on election night and in the weeks that followed that he lost the election by a lot, and that his claims that the election was stolen just were not at all true, and his claims that there were widespread voter fraud was not at all true. This was not Democrats telling him this. This was his own attorney general, his own campaign manager, even his own daughter. And while he accused the left of stealing the election, he was the one trying to steal the election. Clever move, but you're not going to get away with it this time, buddy. And he did it all for just two reasons. One, so he could hold on to power even though he lost. And two, so he could steal money directly from you in fundraising emails and indirectly by starting new businesses like, say, a social network that will make him even more rich. A site called Truth Social, filled with nothing but more of his lies. So look, I get that your brain hurts a little now, and you're not sure how to process all this. So let me try one more time, perhaps in even more basic language, to make it a little easier for you to soak in the information, okay? Man steal money from you, bad. Guy who rob you, bad guy. No worship guy who rob you. No wave flag of criminal who lie to you, steal your money, hurt your family. No wear hat, pants, and very tacky t-shirt of bad guy. That bad guy, Donald Trump. Yup, guy on your t-shirt and 19 flags and 42 truck decals. He bad guy. He trick you. You can keep letting him trick you and lie to you and steal from you, or you can stop. Cool? I mean, these people. I'm Ben Glebe. You can subscribe to my News and Politics podcast, Last Week on Earth. New season coming soon. You can get a ticket to my virtual show, Glebe Off the Top, and celebrate my birthday with me on June 18th and be part of our virtual community. Tickets at benglebe.com and follow me at Ben Glebe on TikTok and Instagram. I am posting a brand new stand-up comedy clip every weekday.